Hello, hello again. So, earlier today we did some reading about sea otters, and you looked at some ways where they live and how do they survive there. So today we're going to be doing a little bit of art to go with our sea otter learning from earlier, okay? So you're going to need a white sheet of paper, your pencil, and an eraser if you have one, okay? We are gonna keep our paper nice and clean. Remember that if you make a mistake, you can always fix it. That's why we have our eraser, right? And all we have to do is try our very best because art is not always perfect. We can fix it and we can make it so that it makes us happy, but it doesn't have to be perfect, okay? All we have to do is try our very, very best. That's all you can do, always. I'm always going to tell you that. Just try your best. So ask yourself, did I try my best? And if you say yes and you believe it, then good job. If you're like, I didn't really try that hard, then you can go back with your eraser and you can try and fix it, okay? All right, let's get started. First, we are going to write the word otter at the top of our page. Okay, so kind of large. Let's see. If you have an eraser, you want it to be about the size of your eraser, okay, at the very top. So otter, we have and then otter has two T's. Otter. Otter. Okay. Now I want to make my otter word a little bit fancier, so I'm gonna add a smaller O inside of my O. I'm going to add a little circle inside of my E. Okay. And then how about we do like a little thick T. And look at, I went over that. I don't like in my drawing, so I'm gonna erase it. I'm gonna make my writing a little bit more fun, a little bit more interesting. Otter, good. Okay, now we're gonna start with the face. We're gonna start with our otter's face. So we're gonna draw a circle. Under our word otter, we're gonna draw a big circle. If you draw a little circle like this, you're gonna have a tiny little otter. We don't want a tiny little otter for our picture today, okay? We wanna make our otter nice and big so that it stands out in our picture. So we are going to draw a circle that takes up a big part of our paper. Now your circle does not have to be perfect because art is not perfect, we said. And also otters' heads are not perfect circles, right? That would be strange if their heads were perfect circles. So you want to try your very best. If you're not happy with it, you can erase it and you can try again. Okay, you can pause the video and you can erase it and you can try again. Another thing that we want to do while we're drawing is we don't want to press too hard with our pencil because the harder we press, the harder it is to erase. So we want to keep our pencil nice and light, like a feather, just nice and light. We don't want to press too hard like this, okay? Now that we have our head, we're going to draw two lines for the body. So the body, we're not going to make it super skinny. You want your body a little bit wide. So I'm going to find the two sides of my otter head. Okay? Not too close to each other because then it's going to have a little body. So I'm gonna draw a curvy line going out like this, and then a curvy line going out like this. Okay, the wider you make it, the bigger your otter is gonna be. The closer they are together, the skinnier your otter is gonna be. Okay. Now, boys and girls, here's a good example. Miss Cortez did not like this line for herself. So I'm going to erase, erase, erase. And I'm going to try again. Okay, I like that a little bit better now. All right. If I go too fast for you, you can always pause the video. All right, pause the video and then keep going. Okay, now we're gonna draw the paw, one of the paws. So the paw is gonna start right up here. So I'm just gonna make a little line to remind me that my paw's gonna start right here. And I'm gonna keep going, going, going about halfway to my body. It's gonna end like right here. Okay. So now I'm gonna draw the paw. I'm gonna make like, think of like a sideways mountain. Okay, so I can even flip my paper like this if I need to. I'm gonna make like a sideways mountain. Like this. Okay, so the paw. You can always flip your paper around to help you. Okay, so I turned it over to help me paint like a mountain or like a rainbow. And then I'm gonna do the same thing on the other side. The other paw is gonna start over here. And it's going to end about right here. And I'm going to draw like a sideways rainbow that's going to meet with the other paw like this. I'm not sure I like that paw too much. It looks a little bit wide for me. So I'm going to make it a little bit more narrow. I'm gonna make it go up a little bit more like that. And I think I'm gonna do the same thing with this side. It's gonna go up a little bit more like that. Good job, boys and girls. Okay. Now we're gonna draw the little ears. The little ears. The little otter ears. Right now it's gonna kind of look like a little bear. So we're gonna draw two little ears at the top of the head. Not right at top, kind of to the side. We're gonna draw two rainbow lines. One and to the side, two rainbow lines. Two. Okay. And then for the paw, we're gonna draw some little lines, like three or four little lines. Okay. Next thing we have is our nose. We're gonna draw the nose. Okay, on the face, we gotta leave some space for the eye. So the nose is gonna go like halfway on the face. We're gonna draw a line, kind of straight, just a little tiny curve, almost straight across. And then we're gonna draw a V, a letter V right under it. So a letter V. Right under it. Kind of like a triangle. You see, I'm not happy with that V, so I gotta keep fixing it until I like it. And I'm not liking it very much right now. That's okay. Miss Cortez, art is not perfect, but I gotta keep going at it until I'm happy with it, right? Okay, I think I'm happy with it now. Alrighty, now we're gonna draw the little lip. So we're gonna draw a line coming down from the center of our triangle. And we're gonna draw two little lips going sideways. And then we're gonna draw the little eyes. The little eyes are just gonna be two dots on, you see where the corners of my upside down triangle are? I'm gonna draw the eyes kind of further out like that. That's a crazy eye right there, Miss Cortez. Okay, and our last step is the whiskers. We need to do the little whiskers. So we're gonna do three whiskers on each side. With that's a total of how many whiskers in all together, how many whiskers? Three and three more makes how many altogether? Six. So we're gonna draw three whiskers. One, two, three. One, two, three. And I did not like where this one went, so I'm gonna fix it. You see, boys and girls, we just gotta keep fixing until we are happy with okay? And here is my sea otter. My sea otter. Okay. Now we've talked about where sea otters live. Where do they live? They live in the sea, the ocean, right? So because we've been talking about where things live, we're going to add some things to our background, okay? Where do sea otters live? They live in the ocean, right? So maybe our background can be blue. And in the ocean, there's a lot of kelp, right? We read that they like to wrap themselves in kelp, which is like seaweed. So we're gonna add some seaweed to our background. And we're just gonna do that by drawing some swirly lines. There's some seaweed in our background. Some swirly, swirly seaweed in our background. Some kelp. And then we're ready to color. We're ready to color our sea otter. So I'm gonna grab my markers. Oh, I think we forgot something, boys and girls. We forgot to do the inside of the tummy. We forgot to do the inside of the tummy. So, we're gonna draw a line all around the center, like a tummy, like a center tummy. Okay, so this line, And we're pretending that the line's going under the arm. So it's gonna start here, and then it's just gonna keep going under the arm. If it helps you, you can draw it like this. And then you can erase it right here. We can erase it where the arm is when you're all done. Okay, now we can color. Now we can color. So the nose is going to be black. Now we want to trace the nose first so that we stay inside of our lines. We want to trace her nose so we stay inside of our lines. Okay. And when we're coloring, we want to try to color all in one direction so that our color looks nice and neat. So you see how my line keeps going in the same direction. I'm not going like this. We want to try to keep going one way. Try to keep going one way, the same way. Okay. And then we're gonna trace the whiskers with the black. For this one, you gotta go really slow and trace over the whisker. If you need to move your paper, move your paper. You see how it feels more comfortable for me if I move my paper sideways. You gotta move your paper to however it's gonna feel more comfortable for you, okay? But take your time. Now I'm gonna move my paper the other way. We're gonna trace, trace, trace. Okay. Another thing that we're going to trace is the mouth. We're going to trace the mouth with some black. And the eyes. And we're also going to trace all around the sea otter with black. Okay, this is going to make the inside of the sea otter make the colors pop a little bit. So we're going to trace all of the lines of the sea otter in black first. Okay, so trace, trace, trace all the sea otter in black. Take your time. Take your time so that your crayon or your marker stays on the lines that you already drew. Okay, follow the lines that you already drew. And again, if you need to move your paper around like I'm moving it, go ahead and do that. All around. You're gonna trace the paws, the body, gonna trace the body, the body. Okay, I'm gonna play some music for us while we do this. Thank you. Okay, keep tracing. Okay, once you've outlined everything in black, then you can start coloring the inside of the sea otter. We're gonna color the inside brown, okay? It's all gonna be brown, most of it, so we're just gonna keep coloring. Remember, try to stay coloring in one direction. You can do big strokes. Like, move your crayon in big lines, but try to keep them going the same way. My black is mixing a little bit with my brown, but that's okay. Remember to move that paper if you need to. We're gonna color the inside here of the tummy a different color, okay? But everything else will be brown. Okay, the inside we're gonna color. You could do either a pink or a tan. Okay, I think I'm going to do the tan, but you can pick that other one. So in the big areas, you can do big strokes with your crayon, but try to keep going in one direction, like this. Instead of going like this, try going in one direction. Hold your paper nice and tight with one hand, and keep going one direction. Okay, we're going to go in one direction. One direction. Then we're going to do the kelp green. Oh boy. Okay. We're going to do the same thing with the kelp. We're going to take our green and we're going to trace the outside of it first. Okay? Trace all the outside of the kelp first with your green. Try your very best to stay on the line you already drew. And do that for all of them. Uh-oh, I got off a little bit. Okay, now that you've traced it, you're going to color the inside. You can color the inside a little bit lighter than your outside. So don't press quite as hard with your crayon. A little bit lighter. Remember, try to go one direction. So it looks like our long line is going up. So let's try to just keep going up. Okay. Just try to keep going up, up, up. You don't have to press too hard. What are you going to name your otter? What are you going to name your otter? Okay. And then for your otter word, you can color that whatever color you want to. So you're going to trace the name whatever color you want to, except blue. No blue, because we're going to do the background blue. Okay. I think I'm going to do mine purple, but you pick whatever color you want. Okay, so trace the word otter. Okay. Trace the word and then color it lightly. Color it lightly. And our last step is to color the background. We're going to color the background blue because the otter lives in the ocean. So again, we're going to go one direction, going up, up, up. Just coloring all around where there's white. Okay, coloring up, up, up. Back and forth in one direction. Back and forth, back and forth, all the way till you cover all the white spots. Okay. I'm going a little fast now, but you guys take your time. If you need to pause the video or you need to go back. Okay, there's my otter, Mr. Otter. Mr. Otter, I don't know what to name my boys and girls. Mr. Otter. I gotta think about it. Mr. Otter. Mr. Sea Otter. I don't know. I have to think about it. I'll let you know tomorrow. You think about your otter's name, finish yours, and can't wait to see them. See you later.